Hi folks, Pete here from Ashton's Cars. Today we're looking at something a little bit different. This is a Renault Kangoo and it's been converted to be a disabled accessible vehicle. It's got three seats inside it and also an access ramp at the back for a wheelchair to come in, so we can have three conventional seats plus a wheelchair fitted, and it's all been done, as you can see, very well. These are quite a desirable vehicle to have. I've got family members who actually have one of these. They are hard to come by, so we sort of snapped this little one up, especially as this car's only done 51,000 miles from new. So I'll show you how everything works on it in a second. Just taking you around the car very quickly to show you what it's like. So we have got, as you can see, one seat here which sits beside the wheelchair user, and then the two conventional front seats. This one is a 5-speed manual with a 1.2 litre engine, very similar engine to what you get in a Renault Clio. The car is a 2004 model, but it's only done 51,000 miles from new, so it's extraordinarily low mileage. And as you can hopefully see by my video and hopefully some of the photos that we've uploaded of this car, it's in excellent condition, very much in keeping with that low mileage. Things that I look for on these are just general wear and tear, really. You will find that high mileage ones, these lights tend to go quite as if they've got a cataract on them, but as you can see, I hasn't done a lot of work. It doesn't look like it's been driven on the motorway either, this car, because there's no stone chips on the front of it, no sort of wear on those lights. So it's quite unusual. I think probably whoever owned this car previously must have used it for sort of local running around with a wheelchair user, as opposed to actually sort of any heavy duty high mileage. The a basic car inside, windy windows, manual adjusted mirrors, but they have got remote central locking, and also you know, they are a very comfortable car to drive if you've ever driven a Renault Kangoo van, exactly the same as that. So the seating position is very good, the visibility is excellent. They do have safety features like twin airbags on them, these cars. Overall, just a very easy car to drive because the visibility is very good because of the high driving position. Power steering as well, so it's nice and light and easy to drive. Obviously this one being a 5-speed manual gearbox as well, anyone can just jump in and drive this from a normal car. Just coming around to the back here, the ramp that we have on this car, it flips and folds out. It's quite easy to use. Essentially, if you just pick it up like so, that clips into place, and this bit here drops down. I should have probably done that before I flipped it up. It drops down like so, and then clips into place. So you don't lose any of the rear visibility with the ramp up, and that's very important. Some of the ones that I've seen have got these huge ramps on them that don't fold like that one. And when you've got that, the problem that you end up with is that you lose all the rear visibility at the car, and they rattle about like crazy. This one I've been driving around, it doesn't rattle. It's very quiet. I've got a spare wheel on the car. Obviously it has to be relocated to here, because normally it would be stored under the floor, but this has got a much lower floor because of the conversion. And then your toolkit just slides down the side there. You've got seat belts here for the wheelchair user, and you've got actual straps there to hold the wheelchair in place when the vehicle's on the go. It's quite easy to use, it's quite simple, and it's very, very effective. So I'll just shut this down, and then we'll shut some of the doors of the vehicle just to give you a little bit of a better view of it with the doors all shut. As I say, this seat here is just a conventional seat belt. It's quite nice to have that that third conventional seat on here for a number of reasons. One, it's more practical, but also it is nice for someone to be able to sit next to the wheelchair user. Certainly it's better if you've got a family member who needs to use the wheelchair. Obviously the sliding doors there are very, very useful as well. One of the reasons that I've got family members who've got one of these is because of their limited mobility. They walk with a walker some of the time. So as well as having that access to the wheelchair facility when they go out, they've also got the ability to be able to just slide this door, put the walker in, and be able to slide the door shut to get into the front of the vehicle. And apparently that's something that's very, very important, because using a normal door means sometimes they are a little bit too far away from the front compartment then to get in safely. So the sliding doors on these are really good. They're also handy for car parks and stuff like that, because it doesn't take up as much space, so you're able to get out with a lot more ease from a sliding door than you are a conventional one. Right, I'll jump in the front of the vehicle and just start it up for you. And we'll have a quick look at it from the outside with those doors all shut. So we'll start it up. It's a very quiet, very smooth engine on this car. But you would expect that, because it hasn't done hardly any miles. It does a quick check to make sure its oil and fluids are all okay, and then it should come up with the mileage in just a second. The mileage, though, is just over 51,000. Conventional heating controls and a conventional, believe it or not, tape deck in this car. So it is a little bit basic when it comes to luxury extras. You could easily fit your own stereo in, but I think it's quite nice in a way that this car's not been messed around with. It's completely unmolested and untampered with. We have got windy windows, but we have got loads of storage. Massive door pockets on this car. You can put your bottles or anything in there, which are quite handy. Nice bit of cubby storage there as well. And as you can see, the instrument binnacle is very, very clear indeed. And if you look at 51,788 miles this car's done, we bought this car from someone in Newcastle-upon-Tyne, all the way up north. And we drove it back to South Wales a day or so ago. And it just drove absolutely brilliantly, and horrendous weather conditions we were driving in, but the Kangoo felt safe, secure, sure-footed on the motorway. And I don't think, looking at this car, it's probably done a journey of that mileage ever in its life before, but it certainly excelled, and it was fantastic to drive down. Being sat up a little bit higher does make it a little bit nicer, I feel, on long journeys. You've got a good view of the road, you've got good visibility in this car, and that makes it all the more pleasant as well when you are stuck in traffic on a horrible rainy day coming back from Newcastle, because you don't feel claustrophobic ever in the Kangoo. And the seats in it are fantastically supportive, so it's actually a very comfortable car to be in. I'll leave it running quickly now, and we'll just have a quick look outside. Now, you can barely hear the engine on this car, which is really good. 51,000 miles, obviously, it hasn't had a hard life. But even then, with an older car like this, you would expect it to be a little bit noisier than this. It's not. It's really quiet, really quite astounding how smooth and good this car is to drive, especially as it's now 18 years old. But yeah, I think very, very clean for its age on the bodywork. You can see it hasn't had a hard life. Come around the back of it. They are wheel trims, not alloy wheels, but they are all matching. They're in good condition. You can see a tiny bit of surface corrosion on that ramp at the back, but we'll get that sprayed black before it goes to a customer. But essentially, that is it's just a surface rust that comes over the sort of steel that they make those ramps out of. The car's recently had a new exhaust system put on it. As you can see, that's all in very good condition as well. There's not really much to show you. I guess there's a tiny mark by there, which we'll be detaching on it. But no, apart from that, there's a little crease there on that door as well. Someone's opened a door into it at some point in its life. It's very slight. As this type of vehicle goes, they don't come much better than this. So it's not the fanciest thing in the world, but it's certainly going to do a very important job for you if you need a wheelchair accessible vehicle. And what's more, it's got so much life left in it, this car, with only 51,000 miles on the clock. These things are built to do 200,000 miles, so you do the maths yourself, but I'm sure that whoever buys this car will have absolutely years of trouble-free transport ahead of them. So if you're interested in it, give me a call, 07932 873 646. This car is available for nationwide delivery. We're happy to bring it anywhere in the UK for you. Also, we are happy to take your old car in part exchange, be it a wheelchair accessible vehicle, a conventional vehicle, or even a commercial. Just give me a call and we're happy to work out a quote to suit you. That number one more time is 07932 873 646. And of course, as you've come this far, please give us a like, a share and subscribe to our channel. We've got plenty of cars in stock, plenty of reviews up online, and you will be the first to know if you are subscribed to us when new stock arrives. There should be a link on screen now for you to hit. Please do that, and please feel free to like, share this video with your friends and family, and obviously comment below if you've got experience of these cars yourself, because I personally, having driven a lot of these wheelchair accessible vehicles, feel the Kangoo is one of the best package ones around, and it certainly doesn't feel like you're in something big and cumbersome like some of its rivals. So let me know your thoughts on that, and thanks for watching, guys. Have a great day. Goodbye.